Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we are going to crochet a strawberry bag using basic stitches. The materials required are 4 ply acrylic yarn, 4 colors red, green, white and yellow, 4mm crochet hook, stitch markers, scissors, blunt needle and beads. Let's begin our project by making a slip knot. After completing the slip knot, work a chain 32 plus extra 2 chains. Now we have completed working our 34 chains. For the round 1, into the third chain from the hook, we are going to work 1 half double crochet. So from the hook into the third chain, we are going to work 1 half double crochet. After completing the 1 half double crochet, place marker in top of the half double crochet. From the next chain, we are going to work 1 half double crochet in next 30 chains. So count it, 1 half double crochet, the second one, and third one. Similarly, work 1 half double crochet until you reach the 30th chain. Now we have completed our 1 half double crochet in 30 chains. In last chain, we are going to work an increase. So work 3 half double crochet increase in last chain. First half double crochet increase, second half double crochet increase, and the third half double crochet increase. Place marker in top of the first half double crochet increase. So in last chain, we worked 3 half double crochet. After placing the marker, turn the project, and now we are going to work in the loops. So from the next loop, we are going to work 1 half double crochet in next 30 loops. So work 1 half double crochet in next 30 loops. Second one and the third one. Like this, continue until you reach the 30th loop. Now we have completed our 1 half double crochet in 30 loops. There will be one loop left alone. Into that loop, we are going to work an increase. So work 2 half double crochet increase and place marker in top of the first half double crochet increase. Now we are in the end of our first round. Remove the marker and work a slip stitch. For the round 2, we are going to work a chain 1. In same chain space, we are going to work an increase. So work 2 half double crochet increase into the same chain space. So first half double crochet increase and the second half double crochet increase into the same chain space. Place marker in top of the first half double crochet increase. After placing the marker, from the next chain, we are going to work 1 half double crochet in next 30 chains. So this will be our first half double crochet, the second one, the third one. Like this, count it and work until you reach the 30th chain. Now we have completed our 1 half double crochet in 30 chains. From the next chain, we are going to work 2 half double crochet increase in next 3 stitches. So remove the marker and work 2 half double crochet, 1 and 2, into the same chain space, work 2 half double crochet. And again into the second chain, we are going to work 2 half double crochet increase. So first one and the second one into the same chain space, and into the third chain, we are going to work 2 half double crochet increase. The first one and the second one into the same chain space. So there will be 6 half double crochet. From the next chain, we are going to work 1 half double crochet in 30 chains. So this will be our first half double crochet, the second one, the third one. So count it and work until you reach the 30th chain. Now we have completed our 1 half double crochet in 30 chain. Into the next two chains, we are going to work an increase. So remove the marker and work two half double crochet in same chain space. So 1 and 2. And into the next chain also, we are going to work an increase. So work 2 half double crochet increase. Now remove the next marker and work a slip stitch. For the next round, we are going to work chain 1 and into the same chain space, into the back loop, we are going to work 1 half double crochet and place marker in top of the half double crochet. From the next chain, we are going to work 1 half double crochet in back loop of next 71 stitches. So continue working 1 half double crochet in back loops all along the stitches. Now we have completed our 1 half double crochet in back loops of 71 stitches. Remove the marker and work a slip stitch. For the next two rounds, we are going to work half double crochet. So work a chain 1 and into the same chain space work 1 half double crochet and place marker in top of the half double crochet. Into the next chain space work 1 half double crochet. So in this round, for the next two rounds, we are going to work 1 half double crochet all along the stitches. So row 4 and row 5 work 1 half double crochet. Now we have completed our half double crochet. Remove the marker and work a slip stitch. In this round, we are going to take a new yarn and we are going to insert the beads into the yarn. So using the sewing needle or a blunt needle, insert the beads into the yarn. So in this round, we are going to insert the beads. Make a slip knot. And work a chain 1. So insert. Now work a chain 1. And into the same chain space, we are going to work 1 half double crochet. And place marker in top of the half double crochet. Now place the marker in chain 6, 14, 22, 30, 38, 46, 54, 62 and 70. So now we have placed the markers. So in the marker chain, we are going to insert the bead. So work 1 half double crochet until you reach the marker. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we have reached the marker. So remove the marker and pull the bead, yarn over, insert into the chain, come out of all three loops. So now we have placed the bead. From the next chain, work 1 half double crochet in next 7 chain, that is till the next marker. So continue working 1 half double crochet until you reach the next marker. In the marker chain, we are going to insert the bead. Now we have reached the marker chain, remove the marker and pull the bead, yarn over, insert the needle into the chain, come out of all three loops. So like this, continue the pattern throughout the round. So into the chain, we are going to work 1 half double crochet into the marker chain, work one bead. Now we are in the end of the round 6, remove the marker and work a slip stitch. We are slip stitching using the next yarn, so slip stitch using the next yarn, that is the yarn without the bead. So for the next 4 rounds we are going to work 1 half double crochet, so work 1 chain and into the same chain space work 1 half double crochet and place marker in top of the half double crochet. From the next chain, work 1 half double crochet in 71 stitches. So from the round 7 to round 10, we are going to work 1 half double crochet. So in top of the bead, we will have a chain. Into the chain also, you work 1 half double crochet. So don't miss any chain, work 1 half double crochet all along the stitches. For the next 3 round, continue working 1 half double crochet. Now we are in the end of a round 10. We have worked 4 rounds of half double crochet. Remove the marker and slip stitch. Now work chain 1 using the next yarn, that is the yarn with the bead. And into the same chain space work 1 half double crochet. And into the top of the half double crochet place the marker. So now we can place the marker for the bead. So in the middle chain between the 2 beads we are going to place the marker. So place the marker in between chains. Find out the middle section and place the marker in top of the middle chain. Now we have placed our markers. You can fold it like this and also place the marker in top of the chain. Now we can work 1 half double crochet until you reach the marker. So work 1 half double crochet in each chain till the marker. Now we have reached the marker, so remove the marker, pull the bead and work 1 half double crochet. Like this, in chains work 1 half double crochet and in the marker chain work 1 bead with half double crochet. Continue the same pattern throughout the round 11. Now we are in the end of a round 11. In marker place we have worked the bead stitch, that is bead with 1 half double crochet. And now we are going to remove the marker and work a slip stitch. And also you can work a slip stitch using the next yarn. Now using the other yarn we are going to work a chain 1. So insert the yarn and work a chain 1. And into the same chain space work 1 half double crochet. This is the yarn without the bead. Currently we are working with the yarn without the bead. So it will be easy to work the half double crochet. So place marker in top of the half double crochet and continue working one half double crochet all along the stitches. So in top of the bead stitch there will be chain. Into that chain work one half double crochet. So like this, continue working one half double crochet all along the stitches. For the next 3 rounds we are going to work the half double crochet, so we will be working 3 more half double crochet round. I will be meeting you in the end of the round 15. Now we are in the end of our round 15. For the next round we are going to work bead with half double crochet. So this round is similar to the round 6. So based on the beads of the round 6, place the marker in the chain. And after the round 16, we are going to work 9 rounds of half double crochet. So from the round 17 to round 25, work half double crochet. Now we are in the end of a round 25, remove the marker and work a slip stitch. After slip stitching, work a chain 1 and cut the extra yarn. For the next round we are going to insert the new color yarn, green color yarn. So make a slip knot and insert in any one of the chain. Work chain 2 and one half double crochet into the same chain space and place marker in top of the half double crochet. After placing the marker, from the next chain work one half double crochet all along the stitches. So continue working one half double crochet all along the stitches. Now we are in the end of the round 26, remove the marker and work a slip stitch. Here we are going to slip stitch in the front loop only. After slip stitching, work a chain 3 and turn the work. After turning the project, we are going to work into the back loop. So work 1 double crochet into the back loop of same chain space. After completing the double crochet, place marker in top of the double crochet. From the next chain, work 1 double crochet into the back loops all along the stitches. So continue working 1 double crochet all along the stitches in the back loop. Now we have completed working our 1 double crochet in back loop. Now we can slip stitch. So remove the marker and work a slip stitch. For the next round, we are going to work a chain 2 and 1 double crochet into the same chain space. And place marker in top of the double crochet. So in this round we are going to work one double crochet all along the chains. So continue working one double crochet all along the stitches. Now we are in the end of a round 28. Remove the marker and work a slip stitch. After slip stitching for the next round, we are going to work a chain 2 and 2 double crochet increase into the same chain space. So first double crochet increase and place marker in top of the first double crochet and into the same chain space work another double crochet. So second double crochet increase. Into the next chain work 2 double crochet. So first double crochet and into the same chain space the second double crochet. And into the next chain again we are going to work 2 double crochet. So first double crochet and second double crochet into the same chain space. So in this round work 2 double crochet all along the stitches. Now we have completed working our 2 double crochet all along the stitches. Now we are in the end of a round 29. Remove the marker and work a slip stitch. After slip stitching for the next round, we are going to work a chain 2. Into the same chain space, we are going to work 1 double crochet. After completing the double crochet, place marker in top of the double crochet. In this round, we are going to work 1 double crochet all along the stitches. So continue working 1 double crochet all along the stitches. Now we are in the end of a round 30, remove the marker and work a slip stitch. After slip stitching, work a chain 1 and cut the extra yarn. Now we are going to insert a new yarn, so make a slip knot and insert into the front loop of any chain. So into the front loop, insert it and work a chain 2 and into the same chain space work 1 half double crochet and place marker in top of the half double crochet. In this round we are going to work half double crochet in all front loop of the stitches. So into the next front loop we are going to work 1 half double crochet and into the next front loop we are going to work 1 half double crochet like this. Continue working 1 half double crochet into the front loop all along the stitches. Pause the video and continue the same pattern. I will be meeting you in the end of the round 31. Now we are in the end of a round 31. Remove the marker and work a slip stitch. After slip stitching, work a chain 1 and cut the extra yarn. For handle, place marker equally on both the side and remove the first marker and insert the yarn. with a slip knot and work a chain 70. After completing the chain 70, remove the next marker, pull the loop through the next side. And slip stitch in next two stitches. After slip stitching in both the chains, work 1 half double crochet into the chains. In the remaining 69 chains, work 1 half double crochet. Now we have completed working our half double crochet into the chains. Now skip one chain and into the next chain work a slip stitch. Work a chain on and cut the extra yarn. Like this work the next handle also. So now we have completed working our handle. Weave in all the extra yarns. After weaving, see the bag looks very pretty. I hope everyone like this bag. So now we can move on to the flower part. For flower, work a magic circle, chain one, and into the magic circle work 10 single crochet. Into the first single crochet, place marker. After completing 10 single crochet, pull the tail end to close the circle and slip stitch in top of the first single crochet. And work a chain on and cut the extra yarn out. For petal, we are going to use white color yarn. So make a slip knot and insert in any one of the chain. And work a chain one. After working a chain one, into the same chain space work 1 half double crochet. After completing the half double crochet, into the same chain space work 1 double crochet. So into the same chain space we work chain 1, 1 half double crochet and 1 double crochet. Now into the next chain, in reverse pattern we are going to work, so 1 double crochet, 1 half double crochet and a chain 1. After completing the chain 1, into the next chain we are going to slip stitch. After slip stitching, for the petal 2, work a chain 1 and 1 half double crochet into the same chain space and 1 double crochet into the same chain space. Into the next chain, again we are going to work in reverse pattern, 1 double crochet, 1 half double crochet and chain 1. After working a chain 1, slip stitch into the next chain. Now for the petal 3, we are going to work the same pattern, chain 1, 1 half double crochet and 1 double crochet into the same chain space. And into the next chain work reverse, 1 double crochet, 1 half double crochet and chain 1. Slip stitch into the next chain. And for the petal 4, again we are going to work a chain 1, 1 half double crochet and 1 double crochet. and into the next chain we are going to work one double crochet, one half double crochet and chain one. And again slip stitch in next chain and work chain one, one half double crochet and one double crochet into the same chain space. In next chain work one double crochet, one half double crochet and chain one and slip stitch into the first chain, that is into the beginning chain. Work a slip stitch. Work a chain one and cut the extra yarn. Weave in all the extra yarn. So now we have completed our flower. You can paste or sew the flower. Now we are in the end of our video. So friends, I hope you really enjoyed this video. If you are new to my video, please subscribe my channel and click the bell icon for the notification. Thanks for watching. Again, I will be meeting you in a new video. Until, take care and bye-bye.